Mr. Chairman, sir, I rise to support the motion of thanks to the President. Brief and cogent, the address has unerringly pointed out the main economic difficulties and the ways and means through which the government and the people of this country are trying to overcome them. It has mentioned the achievements that have been made as well as the difficulties that still remain. The underlying note shows that there is complacency in the address. Sir, living as we do in close proximity to the times, it is difficult for us in this generation to judge and assess all the achievements that have been made. It is but natural that we look at things that have not been done as yet and not towards those things that have been accomplished. But I dare say that the future will recognize that a great deal has been done in the brief span of only a decade. Sir, the face of rural India is changing far more rapidly than we realize. To my mind, the psychological change that is coming over the people of the country is the most important. The people under foreign domination had lost confidence in their own powers. We had begun to believe that we could not do things. Today we have regained that confidence. We are beginning to realize that it is on our inherent ability that we shall have to rely and that we shall be able to overcome our problems through these means. The President's address has rightly focused attention on the fact that the central and the state budgets are deficit and that our foreign exchanges are being strained. At the same time, it is the endeavor of the government to keep to the targets of the 10th plan. Sir, in an admittedly backward country which has to develop in many ways, it is natural and absolutely necessary to have deficit financing. But deficit financing has its concomitant evils and the inflationary spiral goes up and up if not properly checked. It is obviously the endeavor of the government to keep a balance, to go in for deficit financing when necessary and at the same time be careful to see that we do not expect greater sacrifice of the present to build up the future. There is one factor which I would like to bring to the notice of the government which is of equal importance. In our zeal to husband our resources and to utilize them to the best of our ability, let us not do something which may imperil our efforts. Too much scrutiny, too much red tape, and too many difficulties put in the way of those who are trying to implement the actual work does not make for success. I am speaking not in the air. I speak in the light of experience, and I would like to say that it is essential for the success of the 10th plan to see that the authority that implements the plan, a scheme or a project, whether it be a state government, whether it be a project implementing committee, whether it be a district official or a local authority or a community project authority down in the district, must have sufficient resources both in money and in materials placed at its disposal in a coordinated manner in time, and be able to make such alterations that local needs demand. If this is not done, then as we have seen, many months of the financial year are spent in getting sanctions, and the unfortunate person on whom devolves ultimate responsibility to implement the work gets the money at the 11th hour, and in the last few months of the year there is feverish activity. Naturally, this is not very conducive to efficiency, nor is it the best way of carrying out our work. It leads also to unspent balances, which are very, very injurious at a time when our money position is so very tight. Therefore, it is my earnest appeal to the treasury benches to avoid this situation, for I know that if we are anxious, they cannot be less anxious than us. In regard to the allocations made by the Planning Commission to the different states, which will be going through the administrative ministries at the center, they should be made in such a manner that the administrative and finance departments, that of the center and of the states, do not have to irritate checks at every stage. It is true that in a democratic procedure, we have to have certain checks. These are essential, but such checks should not become irritant. It often happens that the authorities which are to bring about enthusiasm to the people in an area have to wait and wait for months, while the people lost their enthusiasm, frustration sets in, and that imperils our plan. The president address has said that in the first year of the plan, we have not been able to go ahead, and the region given is the state's reorganization.